Now to the debate happening all across our state when it comes to the possibility of school vouchers.
This has been a really hotly contested issue. You may hear about them during tonight's State of the State address with Governor Greg Abbott. And our Nicole Nielsen is here to explain what they are and how they could affect you.
In the state of Texas, we already have some form of school choice, meaning families can decide to send their kids to charter schools, private schools, or even homeschool. But what if parents were funded to do those things? With school vouchers, they could be.
The essential function is take funding that goes with a student in a public school and give that funding in some fashion to a family to send that student to a private school.
Think of school vouchers like a scholarship. But where does the money for them come from? Senator Mays Middleton filed Senate Bill 176, which would create an education savings account program. Essentially, families that remove their child from public education would receive the money it would have cost the state to teach their child, about $10,000 a year. Families could then spend it on their other educational endeavors. Advocates say it's a win-win.
A one-size-fits-all system can't serve everybody. And here in Texas, families deserve education options.
But opponents worry families will drop the public school system in large numbers. The concern is less kids in public schools, less money.
We're already strapped for cash. We see that in the number of resources we're not able to provide students, in the number of school employees who are leaving.
Alliance AFT is a labor union representing Dallas ISD and says if anything, schools need more funding.
Can Dallas ISD afford something like this?
No, they really cannot. I don't know any large urban district that can.
The debate over school vouchers comes as the Texas legislature prepares to take on its top priorities and Governor Greg Abbott plans his State of the State address tonight. Lawmakers have advocated for vouchers in the past, but some believe with pandemic-related frustrations among parents looming over the school system, there may be better luck to expand voucher programs this legislative session. In Fort Worth, Nicole Nielsen, CBS 11 News.